Thank you for joining the Algonquin College Accessibility Tutorials. Today we will be discussing how to create accessible PowerPoint presentations. The most accessible way to create a PowerPoint presentation is to use built-in slide layouts. Built-in slides are set so that screen readers will read them in a logical order. To access the built-in slide layouts, go to the Home tab. In the Slide section, select the Layout button and choose the layout from the drop-down menu that best suits your needs. So let's choose a title and content slide. Now we will insert a title and content into the appropriate areas. A key feature to creating accessible documents is consistency, and a great way to keep consistency amongst your slides is to use master slides. A master slide is essentially a design template for a slide layout. Any changes made to a master slide will change all slides that were created based on it accordingly. To access the master slides view, click on the View tab, and then Slide Master in the Master View section. In this view, you can make edits to any of the master slides for that particular presentation. If you choose to create slides from a blank template or add in floating objects to a built-in template, you must consider the tab order. The tab order is the order in which a screen is read by assistive technology or navigated by a keyboard. Since the tab order will not necessarily match the order that the objects appear on the slide, you must manually set it. The tab order is usually from the lowest object on the slide to the highest. Because objects automatically appear on top when they are inserted, the default tab order is from the first object inserted to the last. If you are creating a simple slide, you will most likely to be able to simply insert your objects in the most logical order and make minor adjustments. So we're just going to create a simple slide here. So I'm going to insert some clip art. Doesn't really matter which one I pick. Sure, Santa Claus, why not? And then I will put some text above it just to make a title. So Santa Claus. And then we'll make it a bit bigger to make it actually look like a title. Perfect. Because I inserted the title Santa Claus after the image, it's not going to be in the correct tab order. To change the order of an object, make sure that you're in the Home tab. Select the object and then select Arrange in the Drawing group. In the drop-down menu, you will find tools such as Bring to Front and Send to Back, which can be used to correct the tab order. Make sure that you arrange your slides in a logical order, with headings placed immediately before body text and labels placed immediately before charts and tables. If you are creating a complex slide, such as this one, you may find it easier to create your slide first and then set the tab order. So after you've finished creating your slide, click on the Home tab, select Arrange in the Drawing group, and then scroll down to click Selection Pane. In the Selection and Visibility pane, all the elements on the slide are listed in reverse chronological order under Shapes on the Slide. Elements can be reordered using the Reorder buttons located at the bottom. Next, we will look at slide notes. Slide notes are additional text that can be read by screen readers and may be a useful way to expand on the contents of a slide. The Slide Notes pane will appear when you have PowerPoint open in Normal View. To access Normal View, go to the View tab and click on Normal View under the Presentation View section. Finally, remember that when creating accessible PowerPoint presentations, transitions and animations should be avoided if possible. Transitions and animations are effects that add visual appeal to a PowerPoint presentation. However, they can be detrimental to the ease in which a screen reader detects information or distracting to people with other disabilities. Thank you for joining us in learning how to create accessible PowerPoint presentations.